much, Rosh Hashiva, for speaking today, Gourmet Torah Shalat Bistro, or virtual version. Without any further ado, Shikoyach, Rosh Hashiva. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Rabbi Zizek. And it's a very, very, very sad day. It's a very sad day for me. It's a very sad day for Klal Yisrael today. We lost another Godol B'Torah, a Goyin Olam, great genius in Torah, and a great tzaddik. A tzaddik Yisrael Olam. I know him for many years. I know him for maybe 45 years. And he's an amazing, amazing person. And his Torah and his derech of limud is a derech of menschlichkeit, how he acted. I wanted to maybe talk about a little bit, because the parsha shoftim, and we're going to speak more about shoftim, but we'll talk about shoftim is the shofet. If you speak about shoftim, you can speak about Zalman Nechemia a lot also. Because of course he was a great dayan, sat on the base in HaGadol in Yerushalayim, and he was paskening shailas all the time in all different areas in Shulchan Aruch. He knew Shulchan Aruch. He knew everything in the Shulchan Aruch. I think Baal Peh, knew all the Rebbe Kivagers. You know, you can ask him any place, any Chubas Rebbe Kivager. He could quote it, you know, exactly. He knew, he could talk about, we're talking Gittin. He knew all the places in Europe. Maybe he was 5 years old when he left Europe, but he knew where every river was, every town went next to what river it was. Photographic memory. But his Midas Taibis, like to speak about today a little bit also. Reminded me today, was thinking about it, that someone once came, was a chabrusa of the Chazonish. Person came and used to learn chabrusa. I think he came from Shalim. I think a person came used to learn every week with the Chazonish. Chazonish, you know, was a god lador in his time, and he was an amazing, amazing goyin and a tzaddik. And this person came by near the house of the Chazonish, and he heard wailing and screaming from the house of the Chazonish. The Chazanish was a very calm person. He couldn't believe that he heard all this screaming from the Chazanish house. He never heard any noise there before. He thought it must be from some other area, maybe around the house. He kept hearing this wailing and screaming and crying out. Couldn't be the Chazanish. He got closer and closer. Yeah, it sounds like it's coming from the Chazanish house. So finally he got there and he came to the house of the Chazanish. And he said, and he saw the Chazanish was really screaming and crying so much at the top of his lungs. And he said, Rebbe, what's going on? Like, the Rebbe, you know, the Chazanish was a very calm person. He could paskin shailas and kol haTorah kula. He didn't seem to ever get so upset. He says, well, the reason is, he says, you know, because at that time, he said, he knows that he calls him the Kelev. The Kelev, he says, is barking. The Kelev is barking. He says, Hitler, Yamach Shemo, keeps saying he's going to kill all the Jews. He says, I wasn't afraid. As long as Reb Shimon Shkop was here in the Baruch Be'er, that they were in the world, he says, I wasn't afraid. But now I just got a shmua. He says, I heard Reb Ochver was nifter, and Reb Shimon is gone. He says, now that he says, I'm afraid. What's going to be in the world? We lost these gedolim, he says, what's going to be in the world? So he was screaming, screaming. I think now also when I hear the news, it was Am Nechemia, I lost this year, my Rebbe, very close, the Novominsky Rebbe, the great Novominsky Rebbe, and now the great Reb Zalman Nechemia in the same year. I wonder also, such gedolim the world lost. Such gedolim the world lost in one time, in such a short time. In this period, it's such a difficult period for the world with the corona, what's going on in the whole world. But to lose these gedolim at the same time, to lose them, I'm so worried, you know, what's going to be. We lost the Hatzolah. The Hatzolah, the greatest Hatzolah, you talk about Hatzolah, can help people's lives. But that's all of their Torah, that's all of their Maisim Toivim. That's, I don't know what to say. You know, the Parsha, talking Shoftim, it talks about also about Melochim, talks about a Melech has to walk with a Sefer Torah all the time. And the Gemara says, Man Malka Rabbanan, who are the Melochim? We don't have kings today. We don't have kings. We have Man Malka Rabbanan. Who are the kings? The kings are the Rabbanan. And we think about the great kings, the Rabbanan. So who greater, the great Rabbonim we have in this generation? We have Rabbi Novominsky, now we have Zalman Nechemia, Man Malka Rabbonim, they walk with a Sefer Torah. Zalman Nechemia was a Sefer Torah, walking Sefer Torah. Anything you asked them, any place, anything, any Shulchan Aruch, any Gemara, He was always, he could tell you right on the spot. He used to say shirim in many yeshivas. You just walk in and he would say, what are you learning? What simon? What daf? Right away, many can say maybe in 15 different yeshivas in the same week. Wherever they were holding was a walking sefer Torah. The sefer Torah in his Torah and in his midas Davis. That was his walking around with the sefer Torah. That was the derech of Zalman Nechemia. You know, the end of the parsha talks about Negla Rufa, so that when somebody found a dead body near the city, and they saw, and they didn't know where he came, where he was killed, and measured the closest city, and they come out, the Dayonim, the Beistin comes out, and they say, Yadena lo shavcha damazeh, we didn't do it. And the Chazal say, well, we thought that these great judges, they killed the person. So Chazal say, well, they obviously didn't kill him, but maybe they didn't take care of him. Maybe they didn't feed him in the proper thing, and then he walked out of the city. And maybe because of that, he was upset. He got in a fight. Somebody killed him. So we were garim. Sometimes a person does a very small thing, a very minor thing, and it's a garim. That's in a bad thing. So a kol shekein, a person does a good thing. You know, think about the amount of good things that great people do. How much actions? How much Torah? How much every place he went? Every place he did? Every place he walked? You saw Torah, you saw Chaim, you saw what it's all about. You saw Kiyem Chayinu Baruch Yameinu. He could write Torah on everything. I saw him hours and hours writing Torah without opening a sefer. He can write Shuvas on every place in Kol HaTorah Kula. He was the head of the Encyclopedia Talmudis. He was the head of a Koila in Choshev Mishpat, Dayonis. He was the head of a Chassidish Koila. He was in the Hesder Yeshivas. He sat all over Eretz Yisrael. It was so much, and that was in his Torah. But if you went into him, he was the most modest person. You walk into his house, he was always mechabed you. He was always made you feel you choshev. He made you feel like you're a choshev, a yid. And he had so many people I sent into him. Many boys who were learning in Eretz Yisrael, I sent them in that he should give him a fahir, that he should get smicha. So many boys got smicha from him. He could see right away if the boy deserves smicha or not. You didn't have to test him. Rav Zalman Nechemia could tell in a minute if the person deserves smicha. Rav Zalman Nechemia, Kol HaTorah Kula, was his fingertips. This is the person that, you know, you saw, it was from the altar door. And you say, I remember once a person walked into the Koilal, when I was learning by him in the Koilal, in Har Tzvi, in Gula, a man walked, an old man at that time, he was an older man from Europe, and they are now in Eretz Yisrael. So Rav Zalman Nechemia told me, this person took a bechina on the whole Prima Godim Baal Peh. He knew the entire Prima Godim Baal Peh. And Rav Zalman Nechemia wasn't spoiled from that. He says to me, the Gans Nishnor, the Shach and the Taz, he knew everyone Shach and Taz. But he knew the entire Prima Godim Baal Peh. I remember Zalman Nechemia was spoiled. And he used to give bechinas to boys all over Israel. He used to come and get tested. And he used to get tested on 200 blot Gemara. And any 200 blotches you would be tested on, he would test you right away without opening the Gemara. And they would just test them all over. All they came from all the yeshivas. And he said there was something that you'd see. I remember Rav Hirschler once told me that you saw this person, you saw something with something unusual. It was the Torah was every place, all over the Torah, and with such modesty, such anove. This was a tremendous, tremendous lesson to see what it's all about, to see what Torah is about. Also, I got smicha from him also, but you know, it just that doesn't, he probably gave a million people smicha, so that doesn't mean much, because you know, he was such a nice person, he gave me smicha, but I deserve it, you don't deserve it. Anyway, he was such a tzaddik. You know, I saw that by the first time I came in by him, I had a chavrusa, Yerushalmi Yid, of Shol Mazia. Shol Mazia was seven doiras in of his mishpacha, was from the Talmidim of the Vilna Gaon. There were many, many, seven generations in Yerushalayim, and his father was the Gabbai in the Har Tzvi Shul. And Rav Zeh, with the grace of Talmud Chacham, Rav Nochem Pertsovich used to sometimes say to somebody, oh, you want to know where it is? Ask Rav Shol Mazia, he'll tell you where the Taisus is in your vomit. See, with the grace of Talmud Chacham. So I was Zeuchem one Zman, I learned with him, and he says, why don't you go speak in learning with Rav Zalman Nechemia Goldberg? I said, well, I don't know him. He says, don't make a difference, just call him up and see if you'll have time. So I called up Rav Zalman Nechemia Goldberg, called him up, and I said, you know, I'm learning Chabrusa with Shol Mazia, and I know he learned by you in the Koilo Dayonis. He said, I could call you, maybe you have some time to speak to me and learning a little bit. So he said, yeah, fine. I said, well, when can I come? He says, what about tonight? Okay, tonight you got time? Okay, tonight that time you had time. I said, what time? He said, well, 8:30. Okay, 8:30, I came over to his house. And I remember I was learning Rosh Hashanah, Rav Bezdin. I had my prepared a lot of pieces of Torah. I thought I'm going to say to this rabbi. So it was a great rabbi. I prepared it. I had written down in my notebook. I'm going to come speak to him. He had like 30 different pieces. I'm going to talk to him. I got to point three, and he had already told me for 3 hours he was coming all over Shas, Bavli, Rishalmi, and everything, Shulchan Aruch, Tanya, everything was throwing at me. I was writing it down as fast as I could write. He was telling me every Marah Mokum. That was the first time I met him. And by the time we finished at 11:30, I never met him before, but 11:30 we finished, and he says to me, well, the last bus is leaving now in the Shikun Chabad, my neighborhood's last bus. You want to go back to Beit Pagan? The last bus is leaving now. So he says, if you want to go home, the last bus is leaving. But then he says to me, but you know what? If you go up the steps over there, he said, the steps over there, get roof the trip. Go up the steps, he says, over there you can catch another bus in Shuk Mach and Yehuda. You can catch another bus, and until 12 o'clock you can get a bus. That was the first time I met him. He spoke to me, I didn't even know him. 3 hours he spoke to me, learning, telling me all over Shas. Then he tells me how I can catch the buses to go home. That was the first time. That was only a short lesson about who this person was, how much you can see that the person was just a... He was a Malam and a Tevah, he's Malach Hashem Tzavokis. So when I wanted to come to his koilo, I was learning another koilo, a very fine koilo. Moshe Rav Kook was learning about Shil Foil, and then Absal Jolti was there. It was a beautiful koilo. But I saw this on the Nechemia, I said, I got to go in this koilo. I want to be in this koilo. So I came to him, I said, can I come into your koilo? I heard about you, and I see you. I would love to be in that koilo. He says, yeah, but we don't pay as much. He says, your koilo pays more money, and I think in half a day than we pay a whole day. I said, I don't care. I don't need it. Baruch Hashem. We had other parnasa. My wife was an Israeli. She's teaching. I don't need it. I don't want to learn by you. He says, okay. If you don't need the money, come to the koilo. So I came to the koilo, and I saw him. I saw him in teaching and seeing and learning with people. And I remember once I said to him, Ahora and Chulin, we're learning Chulin at the time. And I said, Ahora and Ataisras and Chulin. And he said, Kuli hai lo medakina. And he said, no, so much it can't be medayik. And Ataisras is too much of a diak. It's too fine of a diak. He said, Kuli hai lo medakina. Okay, Rabbi said, look, Kuli hai lo medakina. So, okay. So I thought it was a diak, but he said, not. So, okay, I accept your opinion. 6 months later, he came to me and he says to me, all of a sudden, out of clear blue sky, he comes over to me and says to me, oh, Shengifuna. And he said, I found it. What you're already found in Chavas, he said, I found the Chavas Das. In Chavas Das, in the back of Shulchan Aruch, he was Medayik, that Diak in Taisvis. So here a man remembered 6 months later, he's talking to him once and learning just on the side. And he says to me, he saw the Diak in the Chavas Das in the Sivas. You know, it just made me feel like $1 million. Then he should remember a diak, a little thing we're talking and learning. And he called it Tarkuli, he had in front of him. All of a sudden, he remembered that little diak in the Taisus. He said, first he said, we're not medayik. Now he said, oh, I see the Sivas. So the diak, some kuli hailo medaykina. That was Rabbi Zalman Nechemia. He came to me and he said, well, you can find it. I remember he was learning once in a chabrusa. A person didn't seem to have much background in learning. And he was sitting and learning with this person for hours and explaining to him like the most basic things. He was like talking to him, explaining to him, like, yeah, person didn't know really too much. Seemed like he didn't have much background in Gemara. Zalman Nechemia was explaining to him like a Rebbe explains to a young boy, and I was explaining with such patience and talking to him and saying over the Gemara to him slowly and clearly till he got every point. He said, yeah, you understand that point. You want to make sure that he got every point clear. That was how he was learning with him. And I saw, the Anova, how a person can act. I remember one time I was walking and learning after a shir or something, we're going home, and I was walking home, I was going to the bus, it was in Gula, I was going to the street, Malchi Yehuda Street, and in the Malchi Yisrael Street, a couple blocks away from the Koilo, and I was walking down. I remember I was walking and talking and learning with the Rosh Koilo, with Rav Zalman Nechemia, a couple blocks, and we're talking and learning and talking and talking. And then finally, after about 10 minutes of walking, I got to my bus stop, and then he said, he got to go home now. And he lived in the other direction. I thought he was walking with me. He was going in my direction. But no, he was walking, talking, and learning with me. So he saw I was talking and learning. So he knew I had to catch the bus. So he walked with me. It was like, he could have said, I got to go home now. The whole day I'm spending in learning in Koilo, I got to go home. And he could have said, tomorrow we'll discuss this. No, but he saw we were talking and learning. So he walked with me. He walked me to the bus. And then he said, oh, no, I got to go home now. That was his... That was the derech of a gadol, not only in his Torah, but in his hanhoga, in his midas tevis. The first time they say he saw that they were for the shidduch, he went. He's married the gadol of the poskim, Gadol Hador, Shem Zalman Auerbach's daughter, Hazal Tzedek is. So they say that the first time he went, and Rav Shlomo Zalman wanted to, he heard about him. He's a big Eloi, he's a great genius in Torah, he knows a lot. He wants to faher him in learning. He wants to speak to him in learning. And, you know, they both were very similar in their godless Torah, in their midas toibas, in their anova, in their modesty. So he said, he wanted to faher him in learning. He said, I think that someone told me, I think they spoke about Bakama for 8 hours. In 8 hours, they were talking, it was Nechemia, you know, he was talking and talking all over the Masechta, every diak. And Rosh Hashanah Zalman says, why, he was so much daik, so much, he knew it cold and everything. And Rosh Hashanah Zalman was very spoiled from him. So at the end, he said, I was spoiled from all your Torah. He said, only one thing is, you never like got excited about all your chedushim. You said so many chedushim. You said so much new ideas, so many insights into the Gemaras, into the Rishonim. Why like aren't you like excited about all these fantastic new chedushim? So he said, no, Rabbi, I didn't say nothing. That we just say over the pshat. That was the way he was. Maybe later on, as a later age, he did think there were chedushim, but that was, you know, that was his hanova. That was his modesty. He said, well, no, I just sang over a bunch of things. Once, you know, when I was many years later, when I was offered a position to go teach in a yeshiva in Kiryat Yavne. And I remember at that time, I had asked some of the Gdolim, I asked the Reb Nochum, I asked the Novominsker, when they thought it was a good job for me, and they both said, yes, it is a good job for you. And there was one fellow in the Koilo by us, I remember, Abzam Nechemia, a guy came over to me, and he said, no, you shouldn't go there, it's not a good place for you, don't go. So I was wondering, I mean, I had my Rebbeim, I mean, the Novominsker, and the Reb Nochum Pertsovich from the Mir. They said it was good. So I went to Zalman Nechemia, and I said, well, this guy in the Koilol, he's one of the members of the Koilol, he says, I shouldn't go to this place. It's not good. I shouldn't go there. Zalman Nechemia, he never said Lashon Hara, but he said, if the person is the God Lador, is a Shach, or something like that, Nachum Folkin, you have to listen to him. He says, well, you're a young man in the Koilol, he says, well, you got to know, teaching Torah is nothing better than that. So you better, I think you should go to the position. So he told me I should go. That was it. That was his hanhoga. And he went all over to say Torah. He was in many, many moshdes. He was a mecholev for many years, the head of mecholev. He was in Sadagera Koilo. The Sadagera Koilo from the Hasidic Koilo. He was the Rosh Koilo of Sadagera. He was the head of Choshe Mishpat Koilo. He was the chief editor of the Encyclopedia Talmudis. He said in maybe 20 different, 15 or 20 different yeshivas all over Eretz Israel, all types of yeshivas. No, there was, by him, every Jew was Choshev. Like somebody said, he was definitely, you know, he loved everybody. He loved all Yidden he loved. He probably loved Goyim also. He was a bit that person that, you know, he had nothing else but love for people. So he said all over, and it was amazing. Just an amazing, the Hanhoge, that you can see it. That I wanted to just say in the end, I thought maybe, you know, to think that such a loss now that, you know, we can't describe that what kind of aveda, the sadness that there is, and for myself and for the client Israel, to lose such a person, who showed us in Sadis Torah, Sadis Chochmah, Sadis his kindness and his derech, that it's just I don't know, it's in our place, it's Chaval de Obden Lo Mishtachin. We can't really. It's not shaykh, I think, to replace such a person, and we just have to try to emulate and follow in his derech. It was just the sweetness and the kindness. And I remember one time I had somebody in my family was not well, and I was very, very tzibrochen. I was very broken, and I was like crying. I felt so sad. I felt really, really down. And I went to him. I went to him in his backyard, and I went over to his house. And I knocked on the door, and I said, the doctors are saying maybe somebody's very sick, and I don't know what's going to be. And Rav Zalman just says, Zayim Beseder, everything will be okay. I just saw on his face, he says that the tzaddik is goyzer, Baruch Hashem, it came out okay, came out good. But that was, you know, it was his hanhoge, he had amuna, and he was right, you know, he knew, he just, it was just, everything was, you know, just seeing him and being with him, I miss him so much, It's a sad day for me. It's a sad day for Klal Yisrael. And I just hope that we should try to follow and emulate that such a tzaddik. And that's okay. I hope that I said over a little bit mashu shmamashu about such a great godel. And that's it. Everybody should try to, Mirtz Hashem, try to follow in his derech and try to also emulate his midas tovas and his love for people, his love for Torah, love for Klal Yisrael. And that's all I could say today.
I want to thank the HaYeshiva for speaking today. And you have a question? Somebody's trying to. Okay. I want to thank the HaYeshiva for speaking, and may the Divrei Hesped serve a nishmaso. I also remember seeing Zalman and Goldberg, come to Karen Biavne, and people were just lining up to get a glimpse and to listen to the Torah of Zalman and Goldberg. And it's definitely a sad day for Klal Yisrael. I want to thank everybody for coming to virtual Gourmet Torah. Mirtashem, next week we will be hearing from Rabbi Dr. Zev Aleph. Same time, Thursdays at 12:30. Please feel free to join us. Wishing everybody in the interim, a wonderful Shabbos, and hope to see you next week. And thank you again to Rosh Hashiva for speaking.
Thank you. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Chodesh Tov.